Start off with the basic specifications. The G-Watch has a 1.65 IPS LCD display with a resolution of 280 by 280. It's equipped with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 400 processor clocked at 1.2 GHz, a 400 milliamp battery, which packs more juice than the Galaxy Gear Live 300 milliamp battery, 512 megabytes of RAM, and 4 gigabytes of storage. It's running Google's wearable OS, Android Wear, which we talked about in another video. Now, the overall design of the LG G-Watch is similar to the majority of the smartwatches out in the market already. It's square and basic. The G-Watch, in my opinion, feels great on my wrist thanks to its rubber watch band, though you can also change the watch band if you'd like. There's really not much to look at with the G-Watch other than the screen. There aren't any buttons or heart rate monitor that was offered with the Gear Live. The LG G-Watch also has an IP67 rating, which means it's resistant against dust and water, and that doesn't mean you can go scuba diving with it, but you can still wear it in the shower or out in the rain. The screen is somewhat responsive, the colors are okay, and the watch faces included are just okay. I actually prefer the Gear Live's more subtle and modern watch faces, but you may disagree. Google recently announced a new watch face APK, so you'll definitely see new Android Wear watch faces in the coming months. The LG G-Watch's display is decent. It's slightly bigger than the Gear Live, though with a lower resolution. The IPS LCD screen on the LG G-Watch is somewhat disappointing. The difference in resolution compared to the Gear Live is much more noticeable. At 280 by 280, it's easier to see the pixelation without squinting, and the screen just isn't as vibrant and good-looking as the Gear Live. Visibility, however, is great on the G-Watch, pretty much in every lighting condition except outside in broad daylight. And if you haven't seen our video about Android Wear devices in sunlight, we'll leave a link down below to that. You'll need to charge the G-Watch daily, which is actually right on par with our experience with the Gear Live, though that had a slightly smaller battery, and most other smartwatches on the market right now last much longer, so this is definitely a huge weak point. I work about 8 or so hours here at the office, and by the time I get home, I still have about 30% battery on my G-Watch. I have my OnePlus connected to my G-Watch all day and receive push notifications from 3 different email accounts. I play games, read and send text messages, and check Twitter notifications constantly. Around 10 or 11 at night, I'd have the G-Watch already in its charger and it's time for bed. The charger that came with the G-Watch is great too, honestly better than the Gear Live. It's square, pretty similar to the watch, and the two connect together thanks to the magnetic strips in the back, which we really enjoy. Let's talk about Google Now integration. The core of Android Wear revolves around Google Now, Google's personal assistant. Android Wear wasn't designed to replace your smartphone, it's just meant to reduce the number of times you pull out your phone. Google Now displays relevant cards of information before you even ask for it, like the weather, how many steps you've taken, or how long you'll be stuck on a 405 driving home. That's not really all there is to it. You can send text messages or reply to someone, set reminders, set an alarm, all by just talking to your watch. And the microphone is surprisingly good on the G-Watch. It's very accurate, and John thought the same with the Gear Live, and we think the microphones on both devices are spot on. So to wrap things up, I'm giving the LG G-Watch a disappointing score of 5.5 out of 10. Why? Because I don't think its core features are fully baked in yet. Yes, it feeds you notification and it tells you the time, but there's really not much more to it. As of now, there's only a few apps on the Google Play Store that are compatible with Android Wear, Evernote, Lyft, and E24 are just a few. There's a lack of consistency in how one uses applications. Thankfully, more are coming by today. There's also a significant learning curve, and even though there's a tutorial for the first time you use it, it'll take a while to get accustomed to the layout. The use of voice commands is a massive improvement for the smartwatch experience because it reduces the number of times you need to touch your watch, but it's still impossible to get around your watch without doing a lot of swiping. When it comes to pricing, LG's pricing strategy is a little confusing. The G-Watch is $30 more than the Gear Live, even though it doesn't add any features or performance benefits, despite offering a slightly larger battery. I'd be surprised if the cost doesn't come down quickly, especially once the Moto 360 makes an appearance. Is the LG G-Watch really worth that much? No, not right now at least. The G-Watch looks good in my opinion, it's simplistic, and reminds me a bit of the G3's exterior design, but it still needs more tweaking. We're hoping the Moto 360 could turn things around for Android Wear, but we're not holding our breath on that. So what are your thoughts about the LG G-Watch? Are you gonna sit it out and wait a few more months until a new device comes out? Let us know in the comments down below, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next video.
Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe right here to be the first ones to know whenever new videos get uploaded. We got a ton of stuff. We do phones, tablets, cars, anything that has to do with consumer electronics that has to be plugged in or uses batteries, we review.